Dear students, welcome back to a new mathematics session. In today's session, we shall discuss the miscellaneous exercise questions from the chapter Complex Numbers and Quadratic Equations. Let's move on to the topic. Let's begin with question number 1. Evaluate I power 18 plus 1 by I the whole power 25 the whole power 3. Here, let's take the given expression I power 18 plus 1 by I the whole power 25 the whole cube. Little bit of calculation we have to do inside the bracket, that is I power 18 plus this 1 by I the whole power 25 we can split as 1 power 25 and I power 25. 1 power 25 is 1 itself and I power 25 we have written in the denominator. Then I power 18 plus 1 divided by this I power 25 we can split as to the nearest even number which is close to 25 and an odd number. That means an even number which is close to 25 is 24. Then 1 balance that we can write it as I power 1. So I power 1 or I into I power 24. That is the way we have splitted I power 25. That is here I power 18 we can write it as I square the whole power 9 because we know the value of I square. So 9 into 2 18, that's why I square the whole power 9 we have written. Plus here I power 24 also we can split. 24 we can split as I square the whole power 12. I square the whole power 12, I as it is, the whole cube. Still now we did not touch this external power, outside power. Only we are doing the calculation inside the bracket. Then I square is minus 1. Minus 1 the whole power 9 plus I square here also there is minus 1 that we have substituted the whole power 12 into I there is that we can keep as it is. Minus 1 the whole power 9. 9 is an odd number. So minus 1 power an odd number means minus 1 itself. Then here minus 1 the whole power 12. 12 is an even number. So minus 1 the whole power an even number means plus 1. So plus 1 into I will be there. Then minus 1 plus 1 divided by 1 into I, that is 1 divided by I the whole cube, that is minus 1 plus here denominator is an complex number, that is I, imaginary part only is there, just we have to rationalize it. That means just to multiply I to the numerator and the denominator, that is into I in, divided by I, that is equal to minus 1 plus 1 into I is I into I is I square in the denominator the whole cube. Again I square value we know that we can substitute minus 1 plus 1 divided by I square value is minus 1. So we have substituted the whole power 3. Minus 1, I divided by minus 1. That is minus I. So minus 1 minus I the whole cube. Then from these two terms, there is minus 1 is common that we can take outside. When it comes out, there is a power 3. That power 3 also will be coming out along with the minus 1. So minus 1 the whole cube into from here minus 1 completely outside. That means there is only one balance plus 1 that we have written. From here minus 1 comes out and there is only I balance. So plus I the whole cube. Minus 1 the whole cube. Minus 1 the whole cube is minus 1 itself because the power is an odd number. That minus we can keep outside. Minus 1 just simply keep minus I in itself. 1 plus I the whole cube. Now A plus B the whole cube expansion. We have done this type of calculations in the previous exercises also. A cube plus B cube plus 3AB into A plus B. By using that we can expand this one, that is minus of A cube, that is 1 cube plus B cube is I cube plus 3AB, 3 into 1 into I is written into A plus B, that is 1 plus I. Minus 1 into 1 cube is 1 plus I cube we can split near to the even number, that is 3 nearest even number is 2. So I square into I we have split it, I power 3 plus 3 into 1 into I, that is 3I, that we can multiply with 1 removing the bracket. 3I into 1 is 3I, then 3I into I, that is 3I square, that is minus of 1. Then here I square's value we can substitute, that is minus 1 into there is an I outside plus 3I plus here also I square value we have substituted as minus 1. What we have done here is just we have removed I square and we just put the value minus 1. That is minus of 1 plus into minus is minus, 1 into I is I plus 3I, then plus into minus minus, 3 into 1 is 3. That is minus of here 1 minus 3, 1 minus 3 is minus 2. Minus I plus 3I, here minus 1I plus 3I, 3 minus 1 is 2, so 2i. Then when we take this minus inside, minus into minus plus 2, then minus into plus minus 2i, so 2 minus 2i. Next we shall discuss question number 2. For any two complex numbers z1 and z2, prove that real part of z1 and z2 is equal to real part of z1 into real part of z2 minus imaginary part of z1 into imaginary part of z2. Here something related to the real part and imaginary parts, the two components of complex number. Complex number is having two components, one is the imaginary part and another one is the real part. Here let the complex numbers z1 is x1 plus iy1 and z2 we can take it as x2 plus iy2. When we consider z1, the real part of z1 is x1 and the imaginary part of z1 is y1. And here when we look at this z2 complex number, the real part is x2 and the imaginary part is y2. First of all, you need to identify and keep it in mind. And the RHS part we can take first, because here only little bit of calculation is there that we can do and keep. That is real part of Z1 into real part of Z2 minus imaginary part of Z1 into imaginary part of Z2. That is real part of Z1, that is X1, real part of Z2 is X2. So X1 into X2 minus imaginary part of Z1, that is Y1, imaginary part of Z2, that is Y2. That means minus Y1 into Y2 that we have written. That is our right hand side. Then Z1 into Z2. We are going for LHS. For that, Z1 into Z2 first we have to do. That means Z1 we have assumed as X1 plus IY1 into X2 plus IY2. Let's remove the bracket. X1 into the second bracket plus IY1 into the second bracket. That is what it is written. Again, just to remove the bracket, that is X1 into X2, that is X1, X2. Then X1 into IY2 means I into X1 into Y2, in order we are writing, plus IY1 into X2 means X2 Y1 into I. Yes, we are arranging, plus I into I, that is I square, Y1 into Y2 as it is. Then X1 into X2 same, then X1 Y2 into I, just we rearranged, plus X2 Y1 into I as it is we have written. I square value we have substituted. I square value is minus 1. So that minus 1 into plus here. Minus into plus is minus. Minus Y1 Y2. I square we have changed as minus 1 and we have multiplied with this plus. That's why here minus came. Then the real parts we can group it. X1 into X2 and here there is minus Y1 into Y2 we have taken, plus in the imaginary part, I we can take common. I if you take common, x1 y2 is balanced in this term that we have written, plus x2 y1 is balanced in this term that is written into I. I is outside. Then in this complex number, that is the complex number which we get while multiplying z1 and z2, we have got the real part as x1 x2 minus y1 y2 and the imaginary part as x1 y2 plus x2 y1. Here LHS what it is asked is real part of z1 z2. So real part of z1 z2 from here we can take, that is x1 x2 minus y1 y2. Now look at our RHS. This calculation we have got x1 x2 minus y1 y2, both are same. That means LHS and RHS are equal, hence the proof. Next we shall discuss question number 3. Reduce 1 divided by 1 minus 4i minus 2 divided by 1 plus i into 3 minus 4i by 5 plus i to the standard form. We have to write this given expression in standard form. The standard form of a complex number we know, that is a plus ib. Sometimes we can consider as x plus iy also. Here calculation is a little lengthy, but we can do it very easily. We can divide it into two parts. The first part calculation is making the denominator a single denominator. Here there are 1, 2, 3 denominators are there. We have to make it single denominator, and then that denominator we have to rationalize it. Means taking the conjugate and multiplying it in the numerator and denominator. Finally, we will get the answer. So let's start. The standard form is a plus ib. This is a required format. And the given expression we have taken, and the first calculation we will do inside the first bracket. Here you can see two denominators, 1 minus 4i and 1 plus 4i, taking the LCM here. So when we take the LCM, just to multiply it, 1 minus 4i into 1 plus 4i, 1 plus 4i into 1, this way multiplication, 1 into 1 plus i, that is 1 plus i. Then minus 2 into 1 minus 4i, this way multiplication, that is written minus 2 into 1 minus 4i. Denominator is 1 minus 4i into 1 plus 4i, the second bracket as it is we are writing. Then remove the bracket, 1 plus i minus 2 into 1 minus 2, minus into minus plus, 2 into 4 is 8i, divided by 1 into 1, that is 1, 1 into I, that is I, minus 4i into 1, that is minus 4i, then minus 4i into plus I, that is minus 4i square, second bracket as it is, 1 plus I minus 2 plus 8i, same, then I square denominator we have to change and we have to put it as minus 1, the remaining, the rest of the things are same, 1 plus I minus 4i minus 4 into I square is minus 1 into 3 minus 4i by 5 plus i. Then 1 plus i minus 2 plus 8i. Denominator, this calculation is pending, that we can do. 1 plus i minus 4i as it is. Minus into minus plus, 4 into 1 is 4. Second bracket as it is. Then 1 minus 2, that is minus 1. I plus 8i, that is 9i. Like terms we are adding. Then 1 plus 4, that is 5, I minus 4i, that is minus 3i, second bracket again same. Then here it is a product, when you do the product of two fractions, multiply the numerators to multiply the denominators, that means minus 1 into 3 minus 4i plus 9i into 3 minus 4i, second bracket, and here denominator also same thing, 5 into the second bracket 5 plus i minus 3i into 5 plus i. Remember here we don't take the LCM, since it is a product, we multiply the numerators and denominators. Then minus 1 into 3 minus 3, minus into minus plus, 1 into 4i is 4i, 9i into 3, that is 9 into 3 is 27i, plus into minus minus, 9 into 4 36, I into I is I square. Then 5 into 5 is 25, 5 into I is 5i, minus 3i into 5, that is 3 into 5 is 15, 15 into I, minus into plus minus, 3i into I is 3i square. You can see here numerator also there is I square, denominator also I square, just substitute its value, minus 3 plus 4i plus 27i minus 36 into I square value is minus 1. Denominator also 25 plus 5i minus 15i minus 3 into I square values minus 1. Then here minus 3 plus 4i plus 27i minus 36 into minus 1. Then minus into minus, that is plus 36. Here also minus 3 into minus 1, that is plus 3. Then we are bringing the like terms together. Here there is a minus 3 and here there is plus 36. It's written together. Then 4i and 27i like terms, just grouping together. Then denominator 25 plus 3, minus into minus plus, 25 plus 3 we group together, 5i minus 15i, that imaginary parts we bought together. Then minus 33 plus 36, that is 33, 4 plus 27, that is 31i, 25 plus 3 is 28, 5 minus 15 is minus 10i. Then here in the denominator there is 2 common, we can take it out so that our calculation will be little easier. 33 plus 31i as it is in the numerator because there is no common factor. In these two terms, 2 we have taken common. 28, 2 taking common out means 14 balance, because 14 into 2 is 28. 10, if you are taking 2 common, 5 balance. So 5 into 2 is 10, that's why. Then here there is a 2 constant, keep it outside, 1 by 2 into 33 plus 31i divided by 14 minus 5i. Now here the denominator is a single term. Rationalize. So our first part is over. You see that first part up to here it is your normal calculation rule. Then we are going for the second part. Second part means rationalizing the denominator. Means take the conjugate, 14 minus 5i conjugate is 14 plus 5i. Multiply it in the numerator and the denominator. That is 1 by 2 constant, keep it aside, into 33 into 14 plus 5i, 31i into 14 plus 5i. Here it is a product, so we can just take term to term multiplication. Then 14 minus 5i into 14 plus 5i. Here no need to remove the bracket because we can use the formula a minus b into a plus b. 1 by 2 into 33 into 14 is 462. Just multiply and check, okay? Then 33 into 5. 33 into 5 is 165 into I. Then 31 into 14, that is 434i. Then 31 into 5, it is 155 into I is I square. A minus B into A plus B is A square minus B square. So 14 square minus 5i the whole square. Then 1 by 2 into 462 plus 165i plus 434i. Here I square value we can substitute as minus 1, that is 155 into minus 1 divided by 14 square is 196. Then 5 square is 25, then I square value is minus 1. In this step, we have substituted all I square values. Then 1 by 2 keep aside. Then 462 minus 155. Here plus into minus 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 155. Like terms together we bought. Then there is 165i plus 434i imaginary part we bought together. Divided by 196 plus 25. Minus into minus plus 25. 196 plus 25 is 221. That is here 462 minus 155 we will be getting 307, and 165 plus 434 we have got 599i divided by 2 into 21 we have written. Then 307 plus 599i divided by 2 into 221, that is 442. No way we can cancel 2 here from the numerator and denominator, so just multiply and write. 2 into 221 is 442. So we split it. 307 divided by 442 A plus IB, that is 599 divided by 442 into I, real term and imaginary part separately we have split it in the form A plus IB. So this is the required standard form. Next we shall discuss the fourth question. If X minus IY is equal to root of A minus IB by C minus ID, prove that x square plus y square the whole square is equal to a square plus b square by c square plus d square. This is actually an indirect question. Here there is a complex number is given to you. X minus iy is root of a minus ib by c minus id. We are asked to prove this statement. Means here x square plus y square the whole square we need. Here x square plus y square how to get, that is the question. X square plus y square we will get by multiplying x minus iy and x plus iy. So x minus iy into x plus iy if you multiply you will get x square plus y square. From that way only we are going to solve this question. So this is the hint here, or this is the key point here. Please keep it in mind. If you don't recall this one on time you may not be able to solve the question. So x minus iy into x plus iy is x square plus y square. Let's check whether we are getting or not. We know that a minus b into a plus b is a square minus b square. So by using that formula if you split, this is x square minus y square. Y square is iy the whole square. A square minus b square format. A is x, so a square is x square. B is iy, so iy the whole square. Now we can do the calculation. X square iy the whole square, that is I square y square. Then I square value we know, that is x square minus I square value is minus 1 into y square. Then minus into minus is plus, so x square plus y square. You see what I said exactly came. So x minus iy into x plus I is iy is x square plus y square. Now given x minus iy is a root of a minus ib by c minus id, that is we can consider as equation number 1. This is x minus iy, but we want x plus iy also. How do we calculate? Quite simple. Just x plus iy calculation is, for what we have to do is replacing minus I by I plus I. So here there is minus I is there, that minus I if you write it as plus I then x plus iy will get. Here also the same change will be coming, minus I change to plus I, and here also minus I change to plus I. So the same changes we are making on the left hand side and right hand side so that the equation will be balanced. So from x minus iy if you want to get x plus iy, what we have to do is replace minus I and put plus I. So we have got the second statement. Now multiplying 1 and 2, that means we need x minus iy into x plus iy, that is equal to x square plus y square. Here x square plus y square only left hand side, that means we need to multiply these two. Let's multiply it. X minus iy into x plus iy is root of a minus ib by c minus id into root of a plus ib divided by c plus id. That is, here we have calculated and kept x square plus y square, that is the left hand side, is equal to two roots are there, root a into root b. Root a into root b is root ab. So we can keep it under one root. So a minus ib into a plus ib divided by c minus id into c plus id under a single root we kept. Now this one put it in bracket, root of a minus ib into a plus ib divided by c minus id into c plus id. Little bit of calculation, a minus ib, this is a plus b into a minus b format, that is a square minus b square. That means a is a itself, that is a square minus b square is ib the whole square. So a square minus ib the whole square divided by c minus id into c plus id, that is c square minus id the whole square. By using the formula, the same formula, a plus a minus b into a plus b formula. Now we can split again, a square ib the whole square we can write as I square b square, it's written c square minus id the whole square we can write it as I square d square, it's written I square value we can substitute a square minus 1 is I square value substituted, minus of minus 1 into b square, here also I square value we can substitute as minus 1, that is root of a square minus into minus is plus 1 into b square is b square divided by c square minus into minus plus 1 into d square is d square. Then we have got x square plus y square, from that only we have started. X square plus y square is equal to root of a square plus b square by c square plus d square. What we want to calculate is x square plus y square the whole square, means we need to square it, that is x square plus y square the whole square is equal to right hand side also square, that is root of a square plus b square by c square plus d square the whole square. Square root and square we can cancel and we will be getting as x square plus y square the whole square is, square root is gone, that is a square plus b square by c square plus d square. This is the required statement which we need to prove, so we can write it as hence proved. Next we shall discuss question number 6, is a quite familiar question. Solve the equation 3x square minus 4x plus 20 by 3 is equal to 0, quadratic equation. So let's take the given equation and multiplying both sides by 3 because there is a denominator. Multiplying both sides 3 means you'll be getting 3 into 3x square minus 4x plus 20 by 3 is equal to 3 into 0. Multiply inside, 3 into 3x square minus 3 into 4x minus plus 3 into 20 by 3 is equal to 0. So the denominator, our aim is to cancel the denominator, that we have done here, just to cancel 3. Then we'll be getting 3 into 3 9x square minus 4 into 3 is 12x plus 20 is equal to 0. A is 9 here, b is minus 12 and c is 20. Remember b is minus 12, sign you have to be careful. By using quadratic formula, x is equal to minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a, we'll find out the solution. Let's substitute it, minus b, b is minus 12, plus or minus root of b square is minus 12 the whole square, minus 4 into a is 9, c is 20, substituted, divided by 2 into a, 2 into a is 2 into 9, that is minus into minus plus 12, 12 square, minus 12 square is 144, then 9 4s are 36, 36 into 20 is 720, divided by 18, that is 12 plus or minus a root of 144 minus 720, this is minus 576, because the bigger term is minus, divided by 18, that is 12 plus or minus, we can take this minus separate, that is minus 1 into 576 by 18. Split it and then take out this square root of minus 1 outside and it will come as I, imaginary number iota. 12 plus or minus I into root of 576 only balance inside, divided by 18. Root 576, we know the value, that is 24. So 12 plus or minus 24 into I divided by 18. Then here numerator 6 is common, we can take out 6 into, out of 12, 6 going out means 2 balance, 6 into 2 is 12. Then out of 24, 6 going out means 4 balance, because 24 by 6 is 4. And here we can do the cancellation, that is 6 and 18 we can cancel and we can write 3 times. Then 2 plus or minus I into 4, that is I4 divided by 3. So thus x is equal to, the solution is 2 plus or minus I4 or 4i divided by 3. Next there are 3 questions, question number 7, 8 and 9. All are solving quadratic equations and try this as homework. Move on to the 10th question. If z1 is equal to 2 minus I, z2 is equal to 1 plus I, find modulus of z1 plus z2 plus 1 divided by z1 minus z2 plus 1. So here also simple calculation only, you need to take little bit care, concentration is necessary, that's all. Modulus of a complex number, that we know that modulus formula is root of x square plus y square. If x plus iy is the general form of a complex number means. So let's calculate z1 plus z2 plus 1 by z1 minus z2 plus 1. Without modulus we have to take and calculate. Z1 value is 2 minus I plus z2 value is 1 plus I plus 1, and again z1 value is 2 minus I minus z2 value is 1 plus I plus 1. Remove the bracket. So 2 minus I plus 1 plus I, there is nothing to multiply, plus 1 divided by, here there is multiplication is there, 2 minus I as it is, minus 1 into 1, that is minus 1, minus into plus, that is minus I, then plus 1. Here only the multiplication in negative sign inside the bracket, that much only is there, the remaining all are same, quite easy. That is 2 plus 1 like terms, and again one more plus 1. So there are three constants, 2 plus 1 and plus 1 that we have taken. There is minus I and plus I divided by denominator, there is 2 minus 1 and plus 1 that we have taken. Then here there is minus I and here there is minus I. No need of grouping like this, directly also you can do from here the calculation. So here cancellation we can do it, that is you can see here that is minus I plus I we can cancel, then here minus 1 plus 1 we can cancel. Then the rest of the calculation work we can do, that is 2 plus 1 plus 1, that is 4, there is no I term, so 0 will be there, denominator 2 is there, then minus I, that is minus 2, that is 4 divided by 2 into, here 2 is common, okay, 2 into 1 minus I, then we can cancel 2 and 4, that is 2 times. Then we can write the answer as 2 divided by 1 minus I. Again, denominator is problem. We have to rationalize, taking the conjugate and multiply it in the numerator and denominator. That is 2 divided by 1 minus I into conjugate of 1 minus I is 1 plus I. So 1 plus I divided by 1 plus I. Then multiply it. Since it is a multiplication, just multiply out the numerator and multiply the denominators. That's all. 2 into 1 plus I divided by a minus b into a plus b. That is a square minus b square. A square, a is 1, so 1 square minus b is I, that is I square. That is 2 into 1 plus I divided by 1 square minus I square value is minus 1. That is 2 into 1 plus I divided by 1 plus 1. 1 plus 1 is 2. Then here also we can cancel the numerator and denominator common term, that is 2, we can cancel. Then we will be getting as 1 plus I. This is z1 plus z2 plus 1 divided by z1 minus z2 plus 1. What we have to calculate is modulus of that particular complex number. So modulus of this one we have to calculate. That means modulus of z1 plus z2 plus 1 divided by z1 minus z2 plus 1 is equal to modulus of 1 plus I. Now it is quite simple. This is the format x plus I y. So the formula is root of x square plus y square. X is 1. That is the real part, and the imaginary part also 1. So root of 1 square plus 1 square, that means root 2. So this is the modulus of the given complex number. Dear students, today we have discussed question number 1 to 10 from the miscellaneous exercise of chapter 5, complex numbers and quadratic equations. There are lengthy calculations are there, so you have to practice it properly. While practicing, if you have any doubt, please mark it and keep. We will discuss it during the discussion session. Thank you for watching.